So first I have a jute placemat. That's going to be the backing of our juju hat. A piece of cardboard cut out in the same shape. Then I have jute rope and some rooster feathers. I bought these in fringe and I love the natural color, but them being fringe is gonna make it a lot easier to create a consistent flow of feathers on our juju hat. Then I have a glue gun, glue sticks, of course, and scissors. The first thing I'm gonna do is take my piece of cardboard and glue it to the back of our jute placemat. The cardboard piece is actually gonna be the front of our hat, and then the jute piece is gonna be the back. What we wanna do then is take our jute rope and start gluing it to the edges of the cardboard and just start building it up. We're kind of creating a little mountain here so that when we start gluing our feathers, they'll bend inwards and kind of create a shallow bowl shape. After that, flip the hat over and do one round of gluing our rooster feathers on the back. This is gonna ensure that it lays flat against your wall when you're hanging it and you won't see any of the cardboard or jute from the sides. So one thing I like to do when I'm gluing the fringe down is try to alternate my fringe based on the bend of the feathers. You wanna try to create as much volume as humanly possible. So alternating, if they're bending inwards, alternate a row and do one that's bending outwards. And then as you're gluing, you want to kind of pinch it in place. What that's gonna do is it's gonna create more volume, and then it's also gonna allow for the fabric to bend in a circle, and you'll get a nice, better rounded circle. And you can really layer these on however you want to. Just keep watching how it starts looking and how much volume is happening. If you wanna keep layering, keep doing that. So as our circle gets smaller, this is where it's really helpful to start pinching that fabric and just keep pinching it. It's, again, creating more volume and it's easier to make a circular shape. So if it's easier, go ahead and cut pieces of your fringe and work those into your circle as your circle gets really, really small. And then now we just need to cover this little blank circle. You see a little bit of fabric from the fringe. And what we're gonna do is just simply cut some of our feathers off of our fringe. And now just cut the ends off. And then just take a little bit of glue and start layering them in. We're just covering that middle circle so that you can't see it and the whole piece looks nice and finished. And voila. Doesn't it look amazing? It adds so much drama to the room and it really is a focal point. And I love how high-end it looks. So these are great for over your fireplace and a lot of people put them over their beds. So if you do this project at home, make sure you share the photos with us. We'd love to see them. And please give us your feedback on this project or any other projects that you'd like to see us do.
For more design inspiration and DIYs, follow me on Instagram @sugarcanedesigns.